good to see you here in the Grand Salon. And yeah, it's nice to be back in here. Thanks for answering Ross's question there about doing the open air concert. You enjoyed that? Yes. Well, you said that earlier on, so I was not. I was so tempted to throw him in the pool there when I was swinging him around, just to cool him off. Well, it's been yet another beautiful day, and I thought, well, very apt to sing "Oh, What a Beautiful Morning," of course, from Oklahoma, from another song by the pens of Rodgers and Hammerstein, and thought of an image there of Howard Keel, of course. He came over with the first ever Oklahoma to come to the UK at the Theatre Royal, Drury Lane, in London's West End. At that time, his name was Harold Keel. There's some debate whether his surname was Harold Leek, and there's a lot of name changing going on, and then of course the Hollywood machine, the MGM machine, snapped him up on a contract. He was about, I don't know what money, but $850 a week, which is a lot of money then, I think. And they still wanted to change his name, and the gossip columnist Hedda Hopper, you heard of her?
Yeah,
she wrote this thing. She saved the day because the studio didn't know what to call him. And she said, oh, this Ava Gardner has been seen with her new chaperone, Howard Keel. And there you got the name Howard. Harold sounded a little bit, maybe in Harold Lloyd or something, I don't know. Then we went to the world of opera, the biggest American export when it comes to operatic pieces. Of course, George Gershwin. Is he there? No, he wasn't there. Oh, there he is, there's George Gershwin. That's, of course, great opera, folk opera set in the Deep South, Catfish Row, Porgy and Bess. And that was Porgy's kind of lazy banjo song. I'm dedicating that to all of you who play in the casino on deck 5. Some of you frequent this little venue? Yes? No? You go in, what do you come out with? There we go. I got plenty of nothing. So I'll dedicate that to you, of course. I'm going to take you to a movie and a great song, the title song from this movie. I mentioned in my first show, being from Wales, from Cardiff in Wales, and Wales famous for its male voice choirs. There are plenty of male voice choirs outside of Wales, in the UK, globally. And I sang with one in England many years ago near Reading, Basingstoke. Anyone from Basingstoke? No, I didn't think so. But anyway, just outside London. And this song they sang, the choir, the male voice choir sang this song. And it was their finishing piece. And in their rows, they sang as they left the stage and went through the central aisle. And with this wonderful diminuendo, this softening and just tapering off of the note. Song is made famous by Bette Midler. And it's a title song from a movie that she starred in about the life of Janis Joplin. So you just have to imagine, don't imagine I'm Betty Little for crying out loud. Just imagine again I'm one little element from a male voice choir. And it's simply called The Rose.
Thank you.
Songs. That'd be too high for me, and plus I couldn't fit the frocks in the suitcase. We have a different character in this particular opera. And incidentally, yes, she works in a cigar factory, and some of you may have seen a rather tall, big Welsh gentleman having the odd cigar in the leper colony on deck 7 behind the square. Have any of you seen me having the odd little cigar?
No.
Never. You need to get out more. You need to get up to deck 7. Well, I do occasionally have, as Franz Liszt, the great pianist composer, said, it closes the vagaries, it closes the door of the vagaries of life. But don't worry, thanks for your concern. Like Bill Clinton, excuse me, I haven't finished yet. You've gone somewhere else, I have no idea. Like Bill Clinton in his college days. I don't inhale. Yes, I have no idea where he was going. Anyway. Yes, the character is Escamillo. He's the bullfighter. And he enters the taverna. Taverna that belongs to Carmen's kind of girlfriend called Lilas Pastias. And she's there, you know, serving all the sangria and the wine, the whole lot. And so this Toreador guy, he strolls in, Escamillo, and he's a megastar. He's the best bullfighter in the world. And he's just describing the excitement and the atmosphere of the bullring and the bullfight. This is not a role that I've played on the lyric stage. I'm a little too hefty to play the bullfighter. Possibly the bull, I could play that. And it's wonderful listening to Harry and Marius, of course, with their wonderful classical tunes that they put into their programs. And it's interesting how the classical tunes work their way into the television commercials. Probably one of the most famous ones, even their kind of corporate music, if you like. A French composer, Delibes, from Lakmé, Don't they pay the flower duet? British Airways, yes, madam. Correct, British Airways used this tune. This tune was used in a TV commercial for Sun Pat peanut butter. And it went yum, 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 yum. So I want you to get it. I need a wonderful little chorus to join in now. Ladies, if you're wearing a shrug or a pashmina, or you can just wave something to the pole, even la 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 if you don't know the words in French, raise your glasses, a wonderful example of a drinking song. If I were the bullfighter, I don't think the bull would survive, would he? I'm just getting him an arm lock, and there'll be filet mignon, steaks, kebabs, burgers, you name it, for months on end. So just join in with the fun of this. As I said, the music is by Georges Bizet, and the lyrics are co-written by Hormel, Dewhurst, Fray Bentos, and Ronald McDonald. Off we go with Four to the Toast, otherwise known as the Toreador Song.
Just here, but no, sir.
And well done you, my little picadors, matadors, and Diana Doris, was she in the show? And the watertight Doris, of course. You need watertight Doris, yes. Well, from an opera from way back when by a French composer. Another French composer and lyricist, Schoenberg and Boublil. We're going to take you to what I think is kind of a modern opera, if you like, but it's packing them out in many, many theatres around the globe still. In my first show, I gave you one song from this particular show, the mask of comedy, if you like, but we'll give you the mask of tragedy in this different character. Of course, based on the epic novel by Victor Hugo, it's Les Misérables. And this character we meet is Javert. He's the chief of police, a troubled character, even born in a jail, so it's said. And he's hell-bent on tracking down the escaped convict, Jean Valjean, who was imprisoned for merely stealing a loaf of bread. So Javert, he invokes the stars to help him in this quest to track down Jean Valjean. So simply from Les Misérables, it is simply called Stars. Guitar player, a fellow beardy weirdy like me, and great singer, of course, great songwriter. It was, of course, Roger Whittaker who had a great hit with that song. Apparently, he hosted his own radio show back in the early 70s, presumably on BBC Radio, and for the life of me, I've forgotten the name of the gentleman who won the competition that Roger Whittaker had set. He wanted his listeners to send in poems or lyrics to a song, and he chose those lyrics. The gentleman was a silversmith, that's all I can remember. I'll try and remember his name. And of course, being covered by many people, including, as we had at the beginning, Howard Keel, the King, Elvis. He's done a version himself, and it's been covered by many people, but I think I do prefer Roger Whittaker's own version, his own rendition. And quite apt, with a bit of a nautical, maritime theme to have the last farewell on, I don't know what kind of ship that was, but don't worry, some of those lyrics don't refer to our journey. Wonderful, the last farewell. But it's not quite the farewell from me, or is it? I think, oh, you're going to pin me down and keep singing here? Well, we'll see. I think, let me just double check. So many shows on this ship now, it's getting hard to remember what I've done and what's yet to come. I'm going to finish with a great kind of anthem, a soft rock anthem, and I suppose the sentiment of this song is relevant today as it was quite a while back, but this time it's the pens of Lionel Richie and the late great Michael Jackson, and a wonderful song, and I've been recently watching on YouTube the behind the scenes. Quite interesting with Stevie Wonder and a host of stars from the world of pop music. And thanks for being a fantastic audience. And I hope you enjoyed my selection and it's not all too heavy. I know some of you like a lot of opera. I think I've put enough opera in. I always say, I don't want it too heavy. I'll just be the heavy part of the act. And we've finished with this great song. And you'll probably know it. Feel free to join in. And it's We Are the World. There comes a time when we need a certain call, and the world must come together as one. There are people lying, and when it's time to lend a hand to life, the greatest gift of all. We can go on pretending day by day that someone, somewhere will soon make a change. We are all a part of God's great big family, and the truth, you know, love is all we need.
We make a better Anthony. We need more from you.
Would you like another one? Let's see what you can do. Is it what? I'm not bad for a Welshman. Well, you're not bad for a Geordie. That's Newcastle, why, hey, north of East of England. Tom Jones was from there. He wasn't Welsh, you know, Tom Jones. He sang a song called Why Yai Yai Delilah. You see, Why Yai Yai there, you know, I spoke to my. A few quick thank yous to Manny and Lorenzo de Ponte on the sound and lighting. And the wonderful Mac here and this wonderful band on board. Fantastic. And great to be working with Ashley, our gorgeous semi-crew director, who's absolutely fantastic. She's always there with water for me. She's like, I feel as if I'm on fire. She's always there to put me out, as it were. Thanks for that. Lovely to see you. Absolutely gorgeous. It's great to work with her again. And of course, Ross, our cruise director. I think he must be. Is he still hosting a table?
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. See, what can you do? We've got to do our things. And it's been wonderful hosting a couple of tables. Have you been on my table? Oh, that's the effect I have on people. There we go. They don't bother coming to the shows. Oh, we've seen enough of it. I think even Ross may have mentioned that a song that he's heard me sing. Some of the guests come up and say, do you know this song? They say the name and I pull their leg and say, no, I haven't a clue how that goes. I do know it, really. Many years ago, I used to be very small. I know it's hard to believe. And when I was a little baby, a little toddler, my grandparents, my maternal grandparents, would babysit me, and I'd be snuggled up in bed between them both, and they would sing me little lullabies. For example, there's this one. Sing lula 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 bye bye. You want the moon to play with, the stars to run away with. Well, I'm not singing that song because you obviously don't know it. Well, maybe some of you do. A wonderful little kind of spiritual lullaby. And in no time at all, I kind of learned the song. So the next time and subsequent times my grandparents were babysitting me, I would start singing. My voice hadn't broken then. So, and in no time at all, my grandparents would be asleep. So I'd lullaby them to sleep. And I looked a good couple of years ago, looked on YouTube, and who do I find singing this song in a concert on YouTube? The late, great Paul Robeson, of course. But he's quite famous for got a few other songs, spirituals, and he was a great actor, great singer, low bass, a bit lower than me, and an activist, of course. But his fame is linked with one particular show. I started with the lyricist, of course, Oscar Hammerstein II in Oklahoma, but we're going back a little further, he's the same lyricist. The show is Showboat, of course, and this is a great song, again, set on a vessel, but not on the high seas, but on the great river Mississippi. So I would like to finish with this song, you all know it, simply called Oh and River.
White man was, show me that
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, Anthony Stewart-Lloyd. Thank you, Anthony.